My name is Richard Koech, a student at the University of Southern Queensland. Our major aim is to improve the water use efficiency of furrow irrigation and also to reduce the labor requirement through automation. Now, just a bit of background about furrow irrigation. We know that furrow irrigation is one of the oldest form of surface irrigation. And in this country, it accounts for more than 90% of all the cotton grown in this country. But because of the issues of labor and the low water efficiency, we came up with this project, and we are trying to look at real-time control as a way of improving the water use efficiency in furrow irrigation. Now, just a bit of what goes on at the moment, the normal practice is that historical data or infiltration characteristics are used to predict future performance of surface irrigation. But what we are doing in our project, we are trying real-time control, meaning that the infiltration characteristics collected in that same irrigation event are used for the management and modification of that same irrigation event. Now, we have come up with a system. We have designed a system, and we have been trialing the system in the field. And just to give a brief of how the system works, we have an advanced sensor which is placed roughly midway in the furrow. I mean, roughly midway the length of the furrow, we place a water sensor. The advanced sensor will tell us how much time has the water taken from the head ditch to the middle point of the farm. So that comes, and the pressure transducer which is put in the head ditch gives us a measure of the pressure head, which is converted into flow rate. So actually, effectively, we are using variable flow rate. So the computer has got a modem, which means the information, the data from the sensors, from the two sensors, is relayed by wireless means into the computer. We have a simulation model which we have developed. So the simulation model does some simulations and tells us what is the most appropriate time to cut off the flow. Meaning, we are going to reduce the runoff from the field, and also this optimal time to cut off is predicted to give us the optimum performance for that set of furrows. Now, at the moment, where we have reached, the turning on and off, because in our trials, we have been using siphons, mm-hmm, and also pipes through the bank. But the main goal in future is to try to automate, to find an automatic system of turning on water and turning off. So when the computer says it's time to turn off the flow, it can actually be done. So we are actually visualizing a system whereby a farmer can sit at home and program everything, and then the water just goes on and off. So in this case, we will be able to reduce the labor requirement of this furrow irrigation system. So that's a bit futuristic kind of a plan.
How far away is that going to be commercialized? Do you think in the next 5 or 10 years you could see this actually being in the field?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to mention what is happening in other forms of surface irrigation in this country. We have the bay irrigation and basin irrigation, but mainly bay irrigation, which is popular for the use of irrigation of pasture, especially in the south. already, that is, there is a lot of automation that is that goes on, because we have gates that are automatic, and in fact some of them are using some simulation model. So the thinking at the moment is some of the technology that is already in use in bay irrigation can easily be used in furrow irrigation. Some of the developed techniques can easily be used in furrow irrigation, and we can easily get to the point whereby the bay irrigation is at the moment. Mm-hmm. Probably we might do some more trials in future. Like I said again, at the moment, the past trials, the turning on and off of water has been manual. So we are looking to future trials whereby we can introduce some automated techniques of turning on and off, and do more trials, so that eventually when the system goes commercial, it's something that has been proven. And also, we might also do some trials in other sites, because we want to try the system in other soil types. We want to see how the system behaves in other soil types. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because, of course, you are aware, the infiltration of water into the soil is also affected by the soil type. What we have been working on is cracking clay, so next time we want to look at other soil types, mm-hmm. and see the kind of data that we get.